Hi everybody, this is Alchemist 2, and I'm back again with another movie review. Well, last night, Dad and I watched The Lincoln Lawyer, and needless to say, this movie was exceptional. It truly was, because it was a labyrinthine ride that left you guessing as to what was going to happen next, and I pretty well had the prime suspect zeroed out, but I had no idea what was going to occur later with the suspect's family, and it caught me completely off guard. I was shocked, and surprising me is quite a difficult thing to do in a film. Is usually I can figure everything out by the end, especially if it's a murder mystery, suspense, thriller type. And I think that Matthew McConaughey is just a consummate actor. He was perfect for his role as Mick Holler. And I also loved William Macy. He's one of my favorite actors of all time, and he never plays the lead role, but he always plays a very strong supporting character role, whether it is comedic or, in this case, serious. And I hadn't seen him in anything for a while. The last thing I saw him in was Shorts, which is, ugh, don't even, no. Terrible film, never should have been involved in it. I rest my case. But, he made up for that considerably in this film, and I give him kudos for it. And he was just a terrific character, and later on in the movie, there's a tragedy involving him, and I'm not going to reveal what that is, because it kind of took me off guard, but I guess it was just a way to get into Michael's head and sort of screw with his psyche and intimidate him. And he didn't take any guff from anybody. He couldn't be intimidated, and he was just badass, to say the least. And he is just one of the coolest characters I have ever seen. And yeah, sure, he represents the scum of the earth, but he made a mistake, and he made it right. And I thought that was fantastic that he did that. And it just shows that all lawyers aren't the scum of the earth. They're not vultures picking at the carcass of their client just to milk them for money. No, not all lawyers or prosecutors are like that. That would be a hasty generalization to make. And he just reveals that throughout the film, and you feel sympathetic toward his character, and you just want to see the best for him, and you know he wants to redeem himself and this man who was wrongfully accused. And he is just a really relatable character, because I think, like all of us, we all have flaws, but we can redeem ourselves, and we can make ourselves better people, and we can help other people get out of the mess that they're in, whatever that mess might be. And of course, I'm actually seeing this come to life with somebody that we're trying to help, and he's going through a really rough time. And I ask for all the prayer in the world, all the positive thoughts, litanies, votives, whatever you have in mind for this individual. I'm not going to say who it is, because I don't want to get myself into trouble, but he's addicted to opiates, and he's trying to make himself better. You have to, if you want to go through rehab, you have to do it on your own accord. And I don't know what that's like, to be honest, but I've been through addiction myself. I was addicted to eBay a long time ago, and addiction is not a fun thing. You become an entirely different person. And there was a character in this film that kind of reminded me of this man, and you gotta pull yourself out of the muck and just clean yourself off and realize that the addiction is not you, that's the alternate you, and I came out of it, and I'm a better person for it, and never again, ever, because I did some things that I never should have done, and I just think that I'm a better person for it, for coming out of it, and I can help other people, even if it's more serious with what they have. And I think with this and the repentance that he makes and the penance that he pays, and he accomplishes his goal in the end, which is, you know, what I really want to drive home with this review, is the best possible feature of this entirely spectacular film. And it's very inspirational and just exciting and really a great movie. I think anybody could watch it, even though there's some language in it, but it's really, you know, tame for an R-rated movie. I think it's mostly violence that made this film an R, because I really wasn't bothered by it, but it's excellent. It is nothing short of fantastic, and I just think that if you're a fan of Matthew McConaughey and William Macy, see it, because it's 5 stars across the board, no questions asked, and 2 thumbs way up. It's one of the best movies I've seen in a long, long time, and just everything about it is perfect. It's not a formulaic movie. It's very twisty and kind of, you never know what to expect. It takes you by surprise, and it grabs you, and you are transfixed to the screen the whole time, and you're not bored at all. It's just, it's that good. So if you have a chance to see it, do so, because this movie rocks.